always be given a chance to go out and perform and show what I could do and not have restrictions and titles and stuff put on. And it was very, very hard. And so, like I said, once I met my my buddy who took care of me and became my manager, Joe Melage, did amazing work. He started taking me everywhere. And with the help of him and my agent, Matt Blake, and we wound up hitting all 50 states. Next thing I know, we go to Canada. Next thing I know, they sent me to Europe. Next thing I know, we hit Australia. And then I get this phone call. My agent calls me up and he says, Gabe, check it out. You're getting a request to perform in the Middle East. I go, really? Okay, cool. Army? Navy, Marines, Air Force, who? Actually, the request is coming from a prince. Run that by me again. A prince. I said, Purple Rain? Not prince. A prince. I said, how do they know me? I don't know, but they say that they know you and they want to hire you. I go, it sounds like a joke, Matt. Trust me, it sounds legit. All right. If it's legit, I'll tell you what. Give whoever a ridiculous figure and let them know that they have to wire the money today. Otherwise, forget it. 4 hours later, Gabe.
What?
Ridiculous just called. Are you serious? I'm looking at the screen, bro. They wired all of it. Next thing I know.
Welcome aboard Saudi Arabian Airlines.
...17-hour flight, you guys, from Detroit, Michigan to Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. And just so you guys know, I didn't go by myself, okay? I took some friends with me. Nobody from this show. For obvious reasons. Yeah, man, you see the crew that I travel with? Everybody's hairy, big nose, goatee, beard, crazy eyes, this. Are you kidding me? With the, all of us, we're like Osama bin Lopez. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what the hell we are. So I took two other friends. I took one friend. His name is Edwin San Juan, who's Filipino, works clean. Hell yeah. And another buddy of mine named Larry Omaha, who's Native American, who also works clean. And, all right, well, hell yeah, sure. Hold on, I want to look at the camera. Hey, Larry Omaha, Edwin San Juan, you guys have fans and they're here in Hawaii. Get your asses over here. Anyway, so we head to Riyadh, 17-hour flight from Detroit. As soon as we get there, they flew us their first class, by the way. It was really nice. And the plane is pulling up to the gate, and you know, it's doing the whole, you know, and the tube is coming out to meet the plane. As soon as the tube touches the plane, all of a sudden, the door on the opposite side of the plane pops open, and a man in a suit gets on, and he walks over to the three of us, and he does this. And I'm sitting there freaking out like, oh my God, this is like the movies. And they pulled us off the plane, and they escorted us to this area called VIP baggage claim. And it sounds kind of crazy, VIP, and I get there, and I realize, oh, they're serving cookies and candy and coffee, and there's leather sofas, and it's really nice. And there's nothing but Middle Eastern businessmen there, okay? And they're all talking about me. I don't understand Arabic, but everyone in this room understands when someone's talking about you. The guy's looking at me and he's like, I'm sorry, but this is universal. And apparently this is Arabic for damn! So then this other guy walks over to me and he's holding a sign and the sign has my name on it and he's really excited. He's like, it is you, come, it is you, come, we go. And I'm like, oh, okay, cool. So we grab our luggage and we follow him outside to the curb. They have three Lincoln Navigator SUVs waiting for us. There's three comedians and there's three cars. We're so paranoid that we're in the Middle East, we all get in one car. We're sitting in there.